Hi, I'm Dan Camarda. Welcome to True Blue Market View. In this video, we're going to be talking about how you can re-encode your videos and even optimize them for streaming applications such as upload and streaming on your YouTube channel. First, head to sourceforge.net in your web browser. At sourceforge.net, search for a program by the name of Handbrake. Download, install, and open Handbrake now. As a quick side note, YouTube does offer information on advanced encoding settings for your videos. Shown on screen here, we see a number of different things that they say to do. Like, for example, the video codec H.264. They suggest to use progressive scan with no interlacing, a high profile, two consecutive B frames, and various other things. One of the things to take note of is that it states to use a variable bitrate. A link to this YouTube article is available here on the YouTube video description, and you can also find a link at truebluemarketview.com/resources. With Handbrake open, we're going to first want to open our source file. Click on the source button at the top left-hand corner of the screen now. Choose File, Open a Single File. Navigate to your source file, select it, and click Open. Next, set the destination file path for your output file that you'll be creating with Handbrake. Next, be sure that you choose the high profile on the right-hand side of the screen. Be sure that your container is in MP4. Put a check in the box for web optimized. Also, put a check in the box for iPod 5G support. However, if your video isn't streaming properly, you can go ahead and try re-encoding with this option unchecked for iPod 5G support. Next, go to the video tab. On the video tab, make sure your video codec is H.264, X.264. Your frame rate should be the same as source, and the quality you should choose average bitrate. In order to determine what a good average bitrate would be, you're going to want to find out what the bitrate of your source file is. On a Windows 7 computer, simply right-click your file, choose Properties, and go to the Details tab. On the Details tab, we see the video length, the frame width, height, data rate, total bitrate, and the frame rate. In this case, the total bitrate is 1,596 kbps. So in this case, I'm going to set an average bitrate of 1,500. The important thing here is that you don't set an average bitrate that's higher than the bitrate of the source file. This is only going to make a file that is larger than the source file, and it's not going to improve the quality. You can also reduce the size of your output file by lowering the bitrate. However, if you lower the bitrate too much, you're going to reduce the quality of the video to the point to where you're not going to like the quality of the video itself, and you're going to want to go back in and re-render that video with a higher average bitrate. Oftentimes, it may take a little bit of trial and error. Under Optimize Video, you're going to want to choose Use Advanced tab instead. Now we're going to go to the Audio tab. On the Audio tab, use the codec AAC, and usually a bitrate of about 128 is more than sufficient, and the mixdown should be stereo. Next, go to the Advanced tab. On the Advanced tab, probably the most important thing is that you set the maximum B frames to 2. You can find additional information about most of these other options by hovering your mouse over each option and waiting for the tooltip to pop up on screen and then reading what it says. That said, I'll typically use the settings that you see on screen here when I'm using Handbrake to re-encode video. Once all your settings have been set, click the Start button to re-encode your video. Preview the video that you've created using a media player such as VLC Media Player, which is available for free, also available through sourceforge.net. And once you see that you have a video that is of acceptable quality, you can simply choose add within Handbrake, set a preset name, whatever options you may want, add a description if you wish, and then click add. This will add it to the list of user presets, and it'll make it a lot quicker and more convenient for you to access it in the future when you go to re-encode other videos. Also note, YouTube does support other file formats. Those other file formats are shown here in this article. For example, you could upload a .avi or a .wmv or an FLV or various other video file types and container types. Having said that, H.264 or the open source format X.264 is very popular and is generally preferred these days. This video codec works well with the MP4 file type or container. This is also why I suggest you use Handbrake and to re-render your file into the MP4 container using the H.264 video codec. Know that Handbrake and other video editing or converting programs won't work with every conceivable video available out there. There are just far too many different codecs and containers. Whereas with audio, things are a lot simpler. But that's not what we're here to talk about today. And with all that having been said, we're about done with this video. Hopefully that's helped you out. Don't forget to subscribe. Come on by truebluemarketview.com. We'll catch up with you guys again in the next video.